Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And we are discussing on radiation heat transfer in module 5. And this is lecture number 5. We are going to solve problems on radiation between three surface enclosure, and in the previous lecture we discussed about the theory part, radiation between three surface enclosure, and we discussed the re-radiating surface. And at the end of this lecture, the learning outcome for this lecture, and the student will be able to solve problems in three surface enclosure with the re-radiating surface. We take the example number 28. Two parallel plates 0.6 meter by 0.6 meter are separated by 0.3 meter. The plate 1 is maintained at 1000 Kelvin and has an emissivity of 0.7, and plate 2 is maintained at 500 Kelvin and has an emissivity of 0.5. The two plates are kept in atmosphere, which can be regarded as black medium at 300 Kelvin. Sketch the radiation network and determine the heat exchange between the plates. And write down the given data. So the plate size is 0.6 meter by 0.6 meter, and distance between the plate is 0.3 meter. The temperature T1 of the first plate 1000 Kelvin, T2 the second plate is 500 Kelvin, and T3 is 300 Kelvin. The emissivity of the first plate is 0.7 and emissivity of the second plate is 0.5. And this is the diagram. The top plate is 0.6 meter, 0.6 meter, and the bottom plate is also 0.6 meter by 0.6 meter, and the height between the space between the plate is 0.3 meter. Surface 1, the plate number 1, the top plate is plate number 1, and it is at temperature 1000 Kelvin and the emissivity 0.7, and the bottom plate is plate number 2 with the temperature 500 Kelvin and the emissivity 0.5. And the third surface is atmosphere, which is regarded as re-radiating surface at a temperature of 300 Kelvin. So this diagrammatic representation of the problem will help you to understand the problem in a better way, so that you represent the problem in the form of a diagram. And this is what the network. So this is the emissive power of the first body and the second plate. And this is what the atmosphere with without any surface resistance, EB3. And this surface resistance of the first plate, R1 equal to 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 epsilon 1. R12 equal to 1 by A1 F12. R2 equal to 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 epsilon 2. And R13 equal to 1 by A1 F13. And R23 equal to 1 by A2 F23. And calculate the surface resistances. So R1 equal to 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 epsilon 1, which is 1 minus 0.7 divided by area is 0.6 into 0.6, which is 0.36 into 0.7, which is 1.19. And the surface resistance for the second surface, 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 epsilon 2, which is 1 minus 0.5 divided by 0.36 into 0.5 equal to 2.78. Now the surface area is 0.36 meter square. And the shape factor. So, referring to the diagram, we have to calculate the shape factor. So, this is the top plate. The largest head is B, and the height is C, and the another side is A is the smaller side, referring to the diagram. But in the problem, A and B are equal. So, A equal to 0.36, 0.6, B is also 0.6, and the C is 0.3. So this is 0.6, this is 0.6, and this is 0.3. Now calculating x value, which is b by c equal to 0.6 divided by 0.3, which is 2, and the y value a by c, which is again 0.6 divided by 0.3 equal to 2. So x and y, the values are 2 each. And in the diagram, x axis I have b by c, y axis I have a by c. For these two values, you have to find out the shape factor F12. So, x equal to 2, you draw the vertical line, it meets the line 2 at a point and read the shape factor. This is F12 equal to 0.41525. So this value is also available in the table in your data book. So the either you can refer to the diagram, or you can refer to the table on the adjacent side. So you can find out, you can read the F12, which is 0.41525. So from the summation rule for the shape factor, F12 equal to 1. So F13 equal to 1 minus F12, which is 1 minus 0.41525, which is 0.58475. Right. Then F13 equal to F23 equal to, this is based on the reciprocity rule. A1 F13 equal to A2 F23. So A1, A2, they are getting cancelled. So this is equal to 0.58475. And the value of the shape factor resistance, R12 equal to 1 by A1 F12, which is 1 by 0.36 into 0.41525, which is 6.69. And R12 equal to R13 equal to R23 equal to 1 by A1 F13, which is 1 by 0.36 into 0.58475, which is 4.75. And value of the emissive power, we calculate EB1 equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4, which is 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 10 to the 1000 to the power 4 equal to 56,700 watts per meter square. And EBT equal to sigma T2 to the power 4, 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 500 to the power 4, which is 3543.75. And EB3 equal to sigma T3 to the power 4, which is 5.67 into 10 power minus 8, 300 to the power 4, which is 459.27. Now the Kirchhoff's law for the node J1, this is EB1 minus J1 divided by R1 plus J2 minus J1 divided by R12 plus J3 minus J1 divided by R13 equal to 0. For J3 equal to EB3, so EB1 is 56,700 minus J1 divided by R1 equal to 1.19. J2 minus J1 as it is, R12 equal to 6.69. J3 minus J1, J3 equal to EB3, which is 459.27 divided by 4.75. And mathematically simplifying, we will get 5.6525 J2 minus 45.39 J1 equal to minus of 1.804 into 10 power 6. Similarly, the Kirchhoff's equation for the node J2, EB2 minus J2 divided by R2 plus J1 minus J2 divided by R12 plus J3 minus J2 divided by R23. And here again, J3 equal to EB3. Substituting, EBT equal to 3543.75 minus J2 divided by R2 equal to 2.78 plus J1 minus J2 divided by 6.69, 459.27 minus J2 divided by 4.75 equal to 0. So solving this equation, this is 13.205 J1 minus 63.58 J2 equal to minus of 121,153.1. Now we have two equations. This is the first equation, this is the second equation, and we have two unknown J1 and J2. We have to solve the two equations and find out what is J1, J2. So this is the first equation, 5.6525 J2 minus 45.39 J1 equal to minus of 1.804 10 power 6. This is equation number 1. And the minus of 63.58 J2 plus 13.205 J1 equal to minus of 121,153.1. Now we have to multiply the first equation by 13.205, that gives 74.64 J2 minus 599.37 J1 is equal to 23.82 to the power 6. And the second equation multiply by 45.39. So that is minus of 2885.89 J2 plus 599.37 J1 is equal to minus of 5.499 into 10 power 6. So adding these two equations, this J1 is getting cancelled. So minus of 599.37 J1, here it is plus 599.37 J1. So these two getting cancelled. So 2811.25 J2 equal to minus of 29.319 into 10 power 6. So J2 equal to 10,429. So the J2 value is 10,429. So using any one of the, using the first equation, 5.62, 5.6525 J2 minus 45.39 J1 equal to 1.804 10^6. Substituting for J2, 5.6525 into 10,425 minus 45.39 into J1, this equal to minus of 1.804 into 10^6. So solving this equation, this is J1 equal to 38,445.7. So J2 equal to 10,429 and J1 equal to 38,445.7. Now, heat exchange between the plate 1 and 2, Q12 equal to J1 minus J2 divided by R12, which is 38,445.7 minus 10,429 divided by R12 equal to 6.69, which is 4187.8 watts. And the heat leaving the surface 1, so Q1 equal to EB1 minus J1 divided by R1. So 56,700 minus 38,445.7 divided by 1.19 equal to 15,339.7 watts. And the heat leaving the surface 2, Q2 equal to EB2 minus J2 divided by R2, which is 3,543 minus 10,429 divided by 2.78 equal to minus 2,476.7 watts. And the heat absorbed by the room, we have the equation Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 equal to 0. So Q3, the heat given to the room equal to minus of Q2 minus Q3, substituting minus Q2 equal to minus of minus, it becomes 2476.7 minus 15,339.7 equal to minus of 12,863 watts. So this is 12,863 watts of energy is given to the room. So we stop here. We solve a few more problem on the same three surface enclosure in the next lecture. So I refer these books for the subject. You can refer to the book for further discussion. And this is the book published by me through another publications. You can refer to this book for further numerical, additional numerical examples. And you can write to my mail ID for any clarification queries, and I will answer the queries sincerely. So thank you. We'll meet again.